Excuse me, I'm looking for Doug Frangelo. I'm supposed to get a swimming lesson from him, and he's supposedly the best in the world. Do you know where I can find him?
Let's see.
Never mind. I think I just found him. Doug Frangelo?
Who wants to know?
I'm Terry James. We spoke on the phone.
Oh, yeah. You're the guy who wants to go for the gold in Beijing.
I know. It's crazy, right? An average Joe with no swimming experience wants to compete in the Olympics. What have I been smoking, right?
You've been smoking dream dust. And Doug Frangelo is about to turn that into reality dust. Okay? So you ready to go? All right, let's take off that robe. You heard me.
I gotta be honest, Doug. I'm a little intimidated. I mean, look at your body.
It really is something, isn't it? Now drop that robe. For swimming.
I'm sure you say that to everyone.
No, I don't. I have never, ever said that to anyone. Except for my wife, 1948 gold medalist Greta Anderson.
1948? That's quite an age difference.
Age is just a number. Besides, the most important number in our relationship is 69. You know what I'm getting at?
I think so.
Do you know the term if there's grass on the field and play ball?
Sure.
Well, there's still grass on that field, and I intend to play ball until the person that grass is on is dead.
Good for you.
Now,
good.
Let's get you strapped in.
Strapped in?
Are you questioning me?
No.
Strap in! Just walk with me. Let's just move a little. Let me get to know your muscles. All right, I like what I'm feeling. You like what you're feeling?
I guess.
Okay, buddy. You ready to do some swimming?
Sure.
Okay. This is called the crawl stroke, a.k.a. freestyle. Get to know it. This stroke is going to be your best friend. All right, here we go. Yes. Good job. He likes you.
Who likes me?
The crawl stroke. Oh, yeah, right there. Good swimming.
Don't we need to get into the pool?
No, no. Before I take the ship out to sea, I like to dry dock it for a little bit. Check out the hull. Okay, let's shift to butterfly. Okay, the motion of the butterfly is like shutting a car trunk. So let's go. You shut that trunk. Yeah? Shut that car trunk. Yeah. Shut that car trunk. Shut that car trunk. Oh, yeah, you're doing great. Hey, did a butterfly just fly into the room and attach itself to me? Seriously, great job.
Yes.
And if this swimming thing doesn't pan out, I think you could make a fortune as a car trunk shutter. Yeah. Now, before we move on to the next stroke, give me a second. I just gotta adjust my penis.
Oh, wait, wait.
Listen, buddy, thanks for the assist.
Okay. You know what? I just don't know if this is working out. I mean, I thought I was gonna get more pool time than this.
Terry, you'll get plenty of pool time after you'd mastered the land fundamentals.
And when will that be?
Like 2 or 3 years, tops.
Okay, that's it. I quit.
Nobody's quitting on my watch.
Let me go!
Oh, no! Come here, you cheesy. No, no, hold on. You know, if you fight, it's just gonna get tighter. If you stop, it's just like a Gordian knot. There you go. All right. That fight out of you yet? You know who you remind me of right now?
Who?
Amanda Beard. She thought land training was stupid too, until it landed her a gold medal.
You trained Amanda Beard?
No. Now, you ready to do this thing?
Let's do it!
All right.
Thus began the first leg of the greatest story in swimming history.
Exactly 1 year later, Terry finally hit the pool where he sank immediately and lapsed into a coma. But 40 years after that, Terry came out of that coma and resumed his training and took the gold medal at the 2048 Coma Survivors Olympics in, you guessed it, Tel Aviv. By the way, in the future, the gold and bronze medals swapped places, and so the gold signified a third place finish. But Terry never said first place, he said gold. How were you paying attention?